Hey, it's Jennifer Priest here, and I want to share with you something really cool that I just made with Adobe Express. Now, this is one of my Instagram accounts, and I wanted to do this branded, like, calling card type of 9-grid because I'm going to stop posting to this Instagram account, and I'm just going to post to the stories. And so I wanted to have something here so that when they came, it was branded, it told them what we do, it has the logo, it's got my other logo on it, I'm on it. So I'm going to show you how I built this in Adobe Express. Now, they've just integrated it with AI, so you can generate all kinds of really cool stuff. Like, isn't that little dog so cute? So you can put directions in here. And I did some playing around with it, and I had it make a mock-up scrapbook room, and it was really fun. But what I'm going to do today is just work on this calling card. So I'm going to go to Instagram Square Post, and it's going to just pull up the square just like we're used to seeing for a regular Instagram post. And I'm going to go here to search. What I really like about Adobe Express is that it coordinates with every other Adobe product that you have. So if you want to pull in your branded assets, like from your library, I have my whole brand kit in there. I'm going to show you guys how that works. Or if you want to use some Adobe Stock, it's all included. And Adobe Express is included inside of your Creative Cloud subscription. So it doesn't cost you anything extra. I'm just going to type in here, colorful background, because I want to have a really pretty colorful background. Now, I could use a template, and there's lots of really cool templates in here that we could use, but I'm not going to use a template today. What I want to do is I just want to get me a colorful background so that I can put that on this post. So we can use photos, we can use backgrounds, and they even have videos that you could pull in from Adobe Stock. So I've got all these really fun things that I could use. Oh my gosh, that one's so super fun. Okay, so I'm going to do this one as if I'm building it. This was one that I actually was looking at for Best Craft Rooms, but I might do it for one of my other sites. I don't know. But there's so much really cool stuff. That one's super rad. That's really pretty. So much really cool stuff that you could do for backgrounds. And these are things I haven't seen anywhere else because they are from Adobe Stock. It's like an exclusive club that you can get this. All right, so I've got my picture there. And so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over to your stuff. And in here, I can click brands and libraries. And these are all things, like some of this is really old. These are all things that are from my branding. So here I can pull up SmartFunDIY, and I've got all my brand colors. I've got my typography, like my different fonts. Okay, so down here on the bottom is my logo. So I can just drag that in. This is a logo I built in Adobe, and I can use it in Premiere Pro, and I can use it in Photoshop, and I can use it here. Everything in my library is pulled in. And so that's what I used to build my other calling card. If you click here on the corners, you'll see the little arrow come up and you can rotate things. Like, isn't that cool? So I'm going to add some text here. So we're just going to say Best Craft Rooms, and that's what I had. Then I'm going to go over here and I'm going to search for fonts. Now, these are ones that I used. But let's see, I don't like the script. There's some recommended ones that I could use. Then I can also click here. And if I scroll down to the bottom, like let's say I get through all these and I'm like, oh, I don't really like any of those. I can click on the button to see more. And I can see even more fonts. So maybe I like this crazy font. Then you can do all kinds of text effects. So I can click here on text effects and I can make an AI text effect if I want. I can create shadows if I want. So here you can see the shadow. So maybe I want that one. I can click on this little adjuster and move stuff around. I can change the color of my shadow. Maybe I want it to be purple. And I can change the distance as well. The other thing you can do is look for other cool stuff. So maybe I want a Polaroid style frame. So I'm going to click on there and I've got all kinds of options and I can just pull that in. So I'm pulling in this picture. It has this white background, but all I got to do is just wait a little bit and it'll load and I can click remove background and it will instantly remove the background. So I can make some little Polaroids on here and tilt those. I can just use Control C and Control V to make copies and add those here. So I've got my two little pictures down here. And I want to show you guys a layers panel. So if you want to select something specifically, you can go through the layers just like we're used to doing in Photoshop and in Premiere Pro. We can see all that in the timeline. We can do the same thing here. We can move our layers around and that kind of thing if we want to do that. Another thing that's really cool is there are mockups. And so I created the phone mockup on my calling card using the phone mockup here. So I clicked it. Again, it has a white background. So I'm just going to wait for it to load. Click remove background, and it's going to take the background away, but I still have all this stuff on the inside and I don't want that stuff there. So I'm going to click erase, and all I got to do is click there. I've got quick selection already selected. It just erases that whole background. Click done. And there I have a transparent background. So now I can take a screenshot from my phone and load that there. That screenshot right there, right? So cool, right? So I've got my logo, I've got different elements here, and now I can add some photos. Now, one thing that's really cool is you can literally just drag and drop your photos into here just like you can if you are working in Premiere Pro or Photoshop. And you can also use the upload button. So if you click media, you're going to have the option to upload from your device. I've got some photos of myself pulled up. I'm going to just drop it right here. And now I have it on screen and I can do things to it, right? I can crop it if I want to make it smaller or more square shaped. I can drag the corners to resize it. I can also rotate it. Like maybe I want it to be in this Polaroid. And so I can resize it to fit in there, etc. Let's go look at what I have that I've already created so I can show you guys how I cut it all up. I also pulled in an arrow and I want to show you guys that because there's a few different arrows in here. There are templates that have arrows. There's photos of arrows. There's backgrounds, there's design assets, and there's shapes. So lots and lots of different arrows to choose from. I think the one that I picked is from icons, but I can't remember. Yes, it is. I picked that one. Okay. So again, with the arrows and those kinds of things, you can rotate them, but maybe it's going the wrong direction, right? So I can go over here and I can mirror it and flip it horizontal and vertical to get it to go the direction that I want it to go, which is so cool. So I'm going to go over to your stuff. And this is where all my stuff is at. There's the one that I was just working on. And I've got this one over here called IG multi panel because I was working on different panels. So here's my whole design. And the way I was designing it, I was looking to see, you know, I want to cut this into 9 pieces. So what I did is I clicked download and it automatically goes for your selected page. So I just downloaded that. And then what I did to cut it up into the pieces is that I opened up a new document that was just the Instagram size. And then I took all the pieces and moved them around here. So I want to show you guys how I did that. Okay, so I'm going to take one of these and duplicate it. So I duplicated that one. And to get that first corner in there, I'm going to zoom out so you guys can see this is how easy this is to do. So I put my first corner up there in the corner, and then I went and took this whole page. And I'm going to go duplicate that page, duplicate page. Okay. And it gives me a new page and I'm going to duplicate it one more time. Okay. So I've got my left hand stuff in there. I'm going to put my right hand stuff in there. So you can see those pink grid lines, they show me when I'm aligned with the edges. So I'm going to do each corner and align that with the edges. And then I'm going to go to the next one down. And this one is still aligned the way that it was in the beginning because it's the copy. So now I'm just going to drag it over and I'll make sure that the top is lined up. And then as I drag it over, can you see that pink line showing up in the middle? That means it's centered. Okay. So then when I put these three pieces together, you can see how they line up. Right? So easy. And so all I did is do that for each row. I downloaded the whole thing, all pages. It came in a zip file. I unzipped it and I uploaded it to my Instagram. And there I have my calling card style Instagram. So easy. with my logo. I didn't have to upload it. I didn't have to build it anywhere. I've got all these wonderful fonts, arrows, mockups, Polaroid frames, a really cool background. Like literally this took me not even half an hour to do. And it's all thanks to Adobe Express. The quality of the content that you get and that you can create with Adobe Express is what you would expect from Adobe. And with this new AI where you can generate these text to image and text effects, more things are coming. It's just really awesome. It's going to open up so much creativity for us and make our creation seamless, right? So we can carry our brand from our libraries in Premiere Pro over to Photoshop, over here to Adobe Express. Just really, really cool and lots of options available. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'd love it if you hit the subscribe button if you want to see more DIY videos like this. I know this is going to be a game changer when I'm starting to create pins and other social media graphics for my business. And I know that it's going to be a game changer for you as well. All right. Thank you guys so much for watching.